do is something a little bit different than the In the Kitchen show. We will be doing an In the Kitchen later this week, but we are at the Living Foods Institute in Georgia, and I actually needed to sneak away to put up today's show. And what I want to do is I want to show you some clips from yesterday's talk that we did, last night's talk in Roswell, Georgia. And I think that you guys will enjoy these because, one, I introduce a problem that's very prevalent in society, and number two, I talk about how you can start on any sort of diet, raw food diet, or whatever you guys are embarking on. So I hope you guys will enjoy it. So take a look and enjoy.
How you act is how you react to what you put in your mouth. Let me say that one more time. How you act is how you react to what you put in your mouth. We have a serious situation going on here. Because some people aren't realizing this very simple fact of nature. Our food has chemical compounds that when we put it into our mouths, our digestive tract, our stomach, actually takes out the nutrients, delivers it anywhere it needs to be delivered into our body, and then causes us to do what we're doing now. So some of us are sitting. Some of us are twiddling their fingers. Some of us have our legs crossed. I'm here talking. These are some of the things that we do. Now, those are very obvious things. Anyone can tell that you guys are sitting and I'm standing up here. The less obvious things are, I can make a list of them, when you are tired, when you are angry, when you are frustrated, when you're feeling lazy, when you can't get out of bed. All these things are a direct result of what you put in your mouth. Now, there's other factors, because food is just one kind of part of this whole health picture. There could be other things happening, but food is so important. And here's what's happening. Here's what scares me the most. This is about as political as I'll get for the talk. But I can't promise you. We'll see what happens. We'll see what kind of questions you bring up. But here's what is happening that scares me the most. Is that the people who are making decisions in our culture, right? The people who are in our schools, who are in our political offices, the people who are doing all these things, making in our religious offices, churches, they are making decisions based on the McDonald's that they ate at lunchtime. They are making decisions on the bacon and eggs and pancakes that they had in the morning. Now, I'm not saying these things are bad. I don't like to label any sort of thing necessarily bad. But these decisions are being made on that fuel. So what happens when someone has a breakfast that may not give them the energy that they need to make decisions? What kind of decision happens in that boardroom at 10 o'clock in the morning? These decisions actually proliferate. Thank you. Now I'm going to ask you guys to help me out here. because my background is not English. So they actually start to compound, and they can create a massive problem.
Hi, my name is Sonia. Just what you were talking about on your circle, and you were saying, well, if your job, your relationship is not working, then you can forget the other. Well, what if you can't get rid of your job or your relationship at this present time? I mean, you know, because I've been stuck with that specific thing, that job or relationship that's kept me stuck. And, you know, I mean, do you believe in, I mean, spiritually, I mean, do you believe in fasting? I mean, to unstick yourself or prayer or, I mean, what do you really start with?
Yeah.
You know, the question? I mean, do you start with the question?
You do. It's because it's so big and it's so hard sometimes, you just have to start with the simple question. First of all, thank you for having us here.
Oh, thank you for being here.
So I can only talk from my own experience, and it started with a question. And because if you were to take the whole picture, I mean, it's overwhelming. It blows you away. It's like, forget it. You know, you can't even begin to think that you know, you'd be able to change all this in a short period of time, because you want to get to where you want to get, but you're here. And you just don't know. I mean, the chasm is just massive. Answering the question to me is like almost stepping on a cliff with a parachute. And sometimes the parachute opens up like right away, and then you kind of just float off, and then you land. But sometimes the parachute comes when you're really, really, really close to the ground. So it gets a little scary. It gets a little hairy when you're going down. But the other thing that I will say about that too is that, you know, ask yourself a question, start small. But I'm of the school that we're only here once, as far as I know. I mean, there's probably some spiritual stuff, and I think that I was actually an Incan in my past life, except that my it's a lot shorter. but you know, because I love South America. But we're only here once, and if you continue to do the same thing, you will get the same results. Right. And if you can, and if you start to do little things differently, which the question allows you to do to open up and be free, then you're able to get some real answers. And then you can decide what to do with the answers or not, because you're going to get answers, and sometimes they're going to be freaking scary. And you'll be like, no, don't want to deal with this now. Next, you know. And you just need to work through it. What I like to do is this: is I recommend, and everyone, this is something you can take with you. I think it's really valuable. I learned this from, you know, some success coaching and that sort of stuff, you know. And it's called the perfect day exercise. And what I recommend everyone do is one day take an hour out of your day or 2 hours out of your day. It's probably going to rain the next week, so, you know, pick a moment of a rainy day, right? And what you do is you take a piece of paper and you take a pen and you sit down and you write your absolute most perfect day in the world on this piece of paper. Now, here's the thing. You have to completely forget about all the ties and all the emotional things that you have right now. Mm-hmm. Completely wipe it away. Write it all down. And everything from how you wake up in the morning, to who's next to you, to who's licking your face, to, you know, like all these different... a pet. Oh, come on, guys. You have a cat. I mean, all these different things. What you eat for breakfast, who you hang out with, who you call on the phone, you know where you are, the weather, all these different details. You write that down. What's going to happen is that around lunchtime, you're going to say, this is ridiculous. Say, this is never going to happen. And then generally around afternoon, you know, maybe it's cocktail hour for someone, maybe it's smoothie time for someone else. Around the afternoon, you start to get into this like little groove where you kind of forget that you're like doing this and you're really visualizing and seeing it. That right there is really, I wish we could bottle that. I mean, that right there is what actually the supplement companies are trying to sell. All right? You know, I looked over here because we have supplements here, you know? Please buy them. But you know, I look at this is what the supplement companies are trying to sell, is they're trying to sell that tiny, tiny bit of emotion that we call passion, right? Because the truth behind it is that people want to get to that point where they are feeling good all the time. And if you can bottle that emotion, you will make all your decisions in a way that are absolutely in alignment with where you're supposed to be. And that type of emotion, what you do is you take this little thing, you fold it up, and then you put it in a place that I call a spiritual toolbox. And you put it there, and whenever you feel like you're feeling down or you're feeling like nothing's working, you pull it out and you read it again. And you just get that feeling again, and then you use that to motivate you over and over again.
Thank you.
So, perfect day.
Perfect day.
That's your assignment.
And very
people
nice.
Are like, oh, I'm doing an assignment. Don't give me assignments. Yes.
All right, so I hope you enjoyed that. Your question of the day is going to be the question that I was referring to in the episode, and that question is, what can I do today to make me healthier than I was yesterday? And that's the question I was referring to. Very powerful question. Go ahead and post that down below. This is Kevin Gianni from The Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.